Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are now ready to carry on with our action and get our next fighters down to the cage. Please welcome half-face fighter fighting out of the red corner, Joel Kane.
You're watching Kingdom Combat Championship. We are back now with a lightweight contest, actually matched at 72 kilograms, Jamie. This is an amateur contest again, three-minute rounds, and the first fighter making his way down to the red corner, Joel Kane of Next Gen.
Again, we talked about gyms in Liverpool, and you know, the gym that's at the height of the minute in the UK MMA is definitely Next Gen, you know, producing such talent. Molly McCann, and of course Paddy the Baddy Pimlet, absolutely smashing it over in America as well now. So great work by them guys, and Molly, a very good friend of ours, Ian.
Yeah, great fighter. Great.
And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome his opponent to the blue corner, Jose Andrea.
So his opponent making his way down to the blue corner is Jose Andrea. Andrea fighting out to TMAS. What do we know about them, Jamie?
I'm genuinely not sure who TMAS are, but Andrea looking like he's ready to rock and roll. His team just behind him there.
So what we do know, Jamie, about Next Generation, you know, one of the original UK MMA gyms. Like you said, Paddy Pimble, Molly McCann, doing exceptional, two of the best fighters coming out of the UK. And again, we talked about how that brings on a whole fight team, you know, the buzz from the gym.
Yeah, exactly, you know, it really is. The gym is buzzing at the minute, that's very, very clear to see. And you know, and growing, you know, very similar to what we've seen with SPG Ireland going back probably 10 years ago with John Kavanagh and the guys there, and how that gym just enterprised, didn't it, Ian?
Yeah, exactly. It's just like we said earlier, iron sharpens iron, and they just get on a real roll. I think I've seen this Joel Kane fight before. Unless the cloning fighters down at Next Gen.
They could well be indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest has been matched at 72 kilograms and will take place over three-minute rounds, and our referee in charge is Simon Small. Introducing our first fighter, fighting out of the red corner and representing Next Generation, Joel Kane. And please welcome his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner and representing Team AS, Jose Andrea!
So 72 kilo catch weight bout, Joel Kane of Next Gen, Jose Andrea of Team AS.
We are seeing more and more of that 72 to 74 sort of kilo, which they call in the light welterweights now.
Yeah, well, they used to do the Bushido weight, 73 kilograms, which I thought was a great weight. I know
Cage Warriors started without just for a little while. Dan Hardy actually was the first champion at 73 kilograms. If he wasn't, he might not be the first champion, but
no, I think he was,
definitely won the title. Yeah. I think he.
Trying to work his way, drag his opponent down. There is Kane. And Joel Kane now in top position. The wraparound on the arm from Andreas.
So nice work, use of the head there from Joel Kane, who's trying to break that guard and stand up.
Yeah, it's always, like you say, that we were talking about this earlier, wasn't we? When you're pushing that head against the fence and you're putting that pressure, it's a really nasty position, especially when you're raining shots down.
Yeah, and then you can see there, Andrea tried to switch to the sweep, but good wide legs from Joel Kane. Now the legs are climbing up, though. This is Jose Andrea looking to try to attack a submission.
Yeah, he's looking like he's potentially going for a triangle there with that really high guard now.
And the great thing about mixed martial arts has always been the fact that you can win from underneath. You know, up until we saw Hoist Gracie in the first UFCs, people weren't seeing people win from underneath. And even if you look at Hickson, you know, in the Japanese events, it was more like control, top position. Hoist Gracie was one of the first guys we saw changing things around. And this is one of the great things about mixed martial arts for me.
A sweep under for that near leg there. Well, we talked that triangle. He's still looking with that really high guard trying to control the head.
We talked about the grappling levels at Next Generation. You can see Joel Kane will have been in that position many times before. And here, controlling position, getting topside control.
Yeah, they've got some of the best young black belts around in the UK, haven't they, at that gym? And, you know, some really good up-and-comers, you know, as they have for many years. They always seem to have the next generation coming through, which is funny, really, because it works with the name. But they have, like, great side control, great top control, really good pressure as well as the jiu-jitsu. So this is really good work here from Joel Kane. Nice and calm. Although Jose Andrea, he's working his hips back in very well, Arian.
Yeah, he's doing well, but then again, look, as soon as that happened, you see Kane switch things up, start hammering those hammer fists in. Those long arms coming down now, he's heavy on that back hip.
He really wants that pass to mount, doesn't he? But
yeah, I think there was no reason for him to rush there. I think he was heavy on the hip. He could have stayed there and landed some real good strikes. And when you are sat on someone's hip with the knees away from you, it's an awful position for the guy underneath.
Yeah, it definitely is. Especially when you know when they're unable to throw the up kicks. Once you start to step off, they can start to throw them up kicks. Especially when you're standing. Jose Andrea does not look one bit tired there. He looks fresh and ready to go again.
I do actually think you look over at Joel Kane, exactly the same, having a sip of some water. And I just think both these guys, this is just shows by like these young fighters here in the start of the career, but the fitness, the conditioning, the training with top level professionals. And this is, for me, every time I come to a UK show, you see the level, the progression, how the fighters are developing so much. I mean, these guys, the level, the jiu-jitsu ability, the striking ability and the fitness they've got, you know, 20 years ago, these were like the top level pros, and these are guys putting in the bottom level. It just shows how over the years the sport progresses so much.
Yeah, absolutely.
You've got to remember, we're still a sport in its infancy.
Second round here, Ian, ready to go.
In round number two, we have Joel Kane of Next Gen, Jose Andrea of TMAS. Kane with the red tape on his gloves, Andrea with the blue.
Not seen much of the striking so far, really. So let's see what.
I do think early on, Andrea looked kind of fluid with the low kick.
Kane closed the distance. Because Kane wants that distance control. He wants to close it and really put the pressure on from the inside. And we've seen his grappling, how good that was earlier on. Oh, a nice, lovely, stiff jab.
Yeah, that's what happens there, though, when you commit to a few too many shots.
And no real defence there, though, from Jose Andrea once it hit the mat.
And here again, like I do talk to my guys often about this being one of the the biggest unforced error in jiu-jitsu, I do believe, is like holding on like this when someone passes your guard. You know, you need to get your elbows and knees back in, get your frames and start to try and better your position.
Especially seeing like the Von Flues and things like that from that position, which is so, that happens so often now. And seeing, you know,
I think that OSP's at 3 in the UFC.
Yeah, he has,
which,
yeah.
You know, Von Flue got 2 and it got named after him, so maybe they should change the name of that one, Jeremy.
Yeah, it should.
Up until that point, it was just a shoulder choke.
The Von OSP. But anyway, we keep working here. We've now seen top control now from Jose Andrea.
Yeah, a nice, reversal by Andrea, then a nice reversal by Kane. Loving looking for that crucifix type of position.
He's working that sort of Paddy Pimblett style back take
it
here.
It really is. He's a gym specialist. He's trying to push the hip back so he can get all the hook in. Paddy did a fantastic job in his last fight of going for the back.
Yeah, he did indeed. He was a very tough opponent as well. He's working on the arm now.
Yeah, again, Jose Andrea.
He can pull like a more, and you continue for that back take though as well. Well, his bottom hip does look a little bit trapped at the minute.
Yeah, I think
so. He needs to sweep it out and then start to work his way over.
Andrea's got his hands locked, I think.
He wants that.
Using that S grip, he's trying to get.
Will he switch to the armbar potentially?
Well, I think Andrea's trying to keep his head just locked there so his arms are safe. He might get caught in a triangle. Andrea again, keep himself nice and tight, keeping elbows and knees close together just to stop that leg getting free. You can see there, Joel Kane trying to get the right leg free. And that's good defense there from Jose Andrea.
Yeah, he's trying to jump
now
over.
He was looking for the pass, then he controlled the head.
Good second round there, in the bag. Two rounds in here, Ian.
Yeah, and again, an interesting two rounds. You can see some definite skills from Jose Andrea, but it's a bit more like he's on the defensive as Joel Kane starts to attack. I do think on the open play with a striking, Jose Andrea clearly has good kicks. But when he committed with too many shots at once, that gave Joel Kane the opportunity to close the distance, front headlock to the floor.
Yep, absolutely. Again, another really, really well-matched fight here, Ian.
Yeah, one after the other after the other. This is fight number 6 now, out of 15. We have a flyweight amateur title fight. 5 3-minute rounds to finish things off tonight. Well, let's get back to this 72-kilogram catchweight bout. Joel Kane of Next Gen, Jose Andreas of TMAS.
Lovely 1-2 there and step off.
Yeah, watch Andre try to use a little bit more distance. He has got good strike and just needs to not commit with too many in the combination early on. Try and maybe pick some single shots. I do think the hand position of Joel Kane looked like he was going to shoot in.
Yeah, he, sometimes in this kind of fight, you've kind of just got to, you think I'm going to take a couple of shots probably on the way in, but I need to get in close and close that distance. And so is that what Kane did really well then? He's now working with, he's controlling them hips from the top. And hands clasped underneath now, and he's trying to work his way through.
Yeah, so control of the legs, trying to keep the hips off the fence is Joel Kane of Next Gen. Jose Andrea trying to keep the hips against the fence. You saw him planting the head down underneath, looking for maybe that 10-finger guillotine or some sort of an attack just to threaten.
Trying to work his way back up with them hands together though, but controlling that hip dexterity there from Andrea, yeah, and again dragged him back down, stepped into that mount now, and now he's in big trouble, Arian.
Well, Kane did a great job there of grabbing the wrist. He was under, he had the both arms under, and he pulled the wrist away that was balancing Andrea, and it just put him down to the floor, and that gave him a good transition to mount.
Stepped in, now he's on top, working his way up. A couple of shots, maybe soften him and try and work for that finish now.
So in the mount position, he's got clean. I say he had clean space there, but he drops back down. Nice hip movement from Andre, who gets back to half, or at least thought at three-quarter guard.
Yeah, good work though again from Kane to see that and to step that leg back over, reset and go straight back into that mount.
Great control in this round from Kane.
Yeah, he's dropped them hips, hasn't he? He's making it really difficult for the elbow knee escape for any kind of movement. You've got to imagine it's probably three rounds down. Good work there though to get that hip back and try and work the keep it back into that half guard from Jose Andrea there.
See, nice solid shoulder there. Shoulder of justice, making his head look away from his hips turned.
Yeah, he's putting the pressure on beautifully, isn't he? Making it really, really awful to be sat in that control.
Yeah, well, he forced the pass there and looking for a knee ride. And see a nice little roll into the leg lock attack, and it worked as a nice defense there for Jose Andrea, but this surely a points victory here for Joel Kane of Next Generation.
Absolutely, yeah, I'd say three rounds there, all goes one way, and you know, Jose Andrea knows that as well, but good work from start to finish from young Joel Kane there. And we'll go to our judges for the official announcement on that.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we please have a big round of applause for both of our fighters? We go to our judges' scorecards, where we have a unanimous decision in favour of your winner, fighting out of the red corner, Joel Kane. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please have a big round of applause for Jose Andrea.
Good win there for Joel Kane, Next Generation, and a good three rounds under his belt. Good experience there for him. Next up, we have another episode of Black Ledge MMA versus Aspire.